Hi friends, welcome to the channel Unshackling Sudokus and Puzzles. Ashish here, and today I'll be covering a puzzle genre called Canal View Puzzle. Now this puzzle comes into the shading puzzle category, and this puzzle is constructed by Prasanna Sheshadri, which was featured on gmpuzzles.com. The idea behind this puzzle is also by Prasanna Sheshadri, so let's see if we are able to crack this puzzle, right? So before going to the puzzle, I would highly recommend you to subscribe to the channel Unshackling Sudokus and Puzzles if you haven't done so. It will really motivate us to cover videos on daily basis. And if at all you have a request for any Sudoku variant or a puzzle genre, do let us know in the comment below and we'll surely make a video on it. And now coming back to this puzzle. So as I already said, this puzzle comes into the shading puzzle category. And the rules of this puzzle are, you need to shade some of the white cells black in such a way that all of the black cells in the grid are connected to each other. So like it's a single group of connected black cells, and no 2x2 cells can be all shaded. So you cannot have four 2x2 cells as this one all shaded, right? And each numbered cells indicate the total count of shaded cells connected vertically and horizontally to that number. So what does that mean? So which means that if you have a 4 here, which means you can have a maximum of, you must have exactly 4 cells that are connected to this 4 horizontally and vertically, right? So if at all you have one more cell here, this would have to be 5 cells connected to with towards this 4, right? Not possible. And now coming on to this, another logic here is 3, this 3. Let us see the example of this 3. You can have 3 cells this way, right? Or you can have 2 cells and 1 cell this way. But you can have only 3 cells, right? 3 cells, only exactly 3 cells that are connected to this number horizontally or vertically. That is what the rule says. Very easy rules, but a really different puzzle genre. And the idea or the logic that is applied in this puzzle genre is really different, right? So again, I'll brief you with the rules. You need to shade some white cells black in such a way that you form a single connected group of shaded cells, which cannot have 2 into 2 group of all cells shaded. And each number cells indicates the total count of shaded cells connected vertically and horizontally to that number, right? And with that, we'll start solving this puzzle. So usually what we do in cave puzzle, it is kind of a variation of a cave puzzle. And usually what we do in a cave puzzle is that you count the number of cells in each side and see that a minimum of how many cells can be shaded, right? The same way we'll do here. For the 6, for example, you have only 4 cells and 4 cells here, which means that at least 2 cells in each side will have to be shaded. So if you don't have this cell as shaded, you'll have only maximum of 4 cells shaded in this side, but you actually contradict the 3 with the 4 cells shaded, right? So minimum of 2 cells in each side, and in this side you can have only 3 cells shaded. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you'll need to have 3 cells shaded here, right? Same way for the 5. You can have only 3 cells towards this side. So 2 cells at least would have to be this side, and 6 is already fulfilled now, right? 6 is done. So for the 5 to be done, you will have one more cell shaded, and 5 is also done. Easy. For the 3, at least this cell would have to be shaded, or else you won't have enough number of shaded cells towards this direction. For the 2 here, so now comes the good part here. For the 2, both of these cells cannot be shaded, right? So at least this cell would have to be shaded, because if both of these cells are shaded, you'll have 2 into 2 group of cells shaded. So at least one can be shaded here, but this, I mean to say, at most one can be shaded here, and at least one cell would have to be shaded here. Same way for the 4 here, at least this cell would have to be shaded, because all the 4 cells cannot be here, thus one will get a contradiction here. So for this 4, at least one cell, this would have to be shaded, because all the 4 cells cannot be here. For this 3, at least this cell would have to be shaded. For this 4, at least this cell. For this 3, these 2 cells will have to be shaded. And again, you cannot shade this cell, because that both of these 3 will be contradicting. So for this 3, we have 3 cells shaded, and for this 3, we have 3 cells shaded here, right? And now the next rule that we know about this puzzle is, you need to have all the black cells connected to each other. So this black cell would have to come out this way. No two into two group of cells can be shaded, right? And this shaded cell would have to come out this way. This shaded cell will have to come out this way. 5 is also done. 6 is done. Oh, 2 is not yet done. So I wouldn't mark this here. Okay, we have done till this one. Oh, that's nice. The logic with 4. You can have only one cell, utmost one cell shaded here, because you cannot have more than one. You'll have 2 into 2 group of shaded cells. So at least 3 cells would have to be here. And which means that the 4th cell would have to be here only. 4 is also done. 2 is also done now. This 3 can also be done. And which means this 2 is also done. What a great start to this puzzle. A really good one. I would highly recommend you to please check the GM puzzle website where I have taken this puzzle from. You will find a very high quality, excellent amount of puzzles and sudokus there on the website gmpuzzles.com. I will add the link in the description below. Please do have a look at the website. You will really enjoy the quality over there, right? And if you see the this shaded cell would have to come out this way, and this shaded cell would have to come out this way. This would have to be unshaded because no 2 into 2 group of shaded cells. So this has to come out this way. And which means that this group of shaded cell would have to come out this way. It cannot come out this way, right? It would have to come out this way. Okay. So if you see the 4 now, 2 cells are already shaded. You need 2 more cells. You cannot have 2 cells here, that would be 3. You cannot have 2 cells here, that would be again 3. Which means that both the areas will have 1 cell each. Wow. So the 4 is also done now. 3 will come out this way, come out this way. Okay. What else can we do here? Can we do something with the 7 here? 1, 2, 3, 4. At least, no, that is not yet right. So this is unshaded, of course. Number cells cannot be shaded, right? That is not part of the shading here. But I won't mark those now. Because I'll just mark the numbers whenever I know that those numbers are fulfilled, right? I'll mark them. And if you see this 4 now, you can have maximum of 2 cells here, not more than 2, because you'll have 2 into 2 group of shaded cells here, which means 2 cells would have to be here this way. And you can have maximum of 3 cells this way, so 1 cell would have to be this way. Nice. Same way for the 3 here, you can have at most 1 cell here, 2 cells would have to be here. That actually unshades this cell. Now for the 4 here, all of these 3 cells would have to be shaded. So 4 is also fulfilled now. This one have to be fulfilled this way. And it has to go out this way. Okay. For the 7 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you cannot have this as shaded. So at least this cell would have to be shaded. And again this cell. If this cell is not shaded, what happens? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6 and 7, no, not possible. So this cell and this cell would have to be shaded, and 7 is fulfilled now. Right? Nice. Okay, let's see what else you can go here. If this is shaded, both of these becomes unshaded, and you won't have enough cells for the 4 to be fulfilled. Right? Excellent. Or another way to see this logic is, can both of these be shaded? Yeah, that is still possible. Oh, so this is only the good way to see that. If you have this cell as shaded, both of these becomes unshaded, and there is no enough room for the 4 to be fulfilled. You'll have both of these cells, and that will have 5 cells shaded and one more contradiction is 2 into 2 group of shaded cells. So which means this is unshaded, this would be shaded. You already have 3 cells shaded for the 4, 1, 2 and 3. Fourth cell cannot be this because you'll have 5 cells together. So this would have to be the fourth cell. Nice. 4 is also fulfilled. Okay. For the 3 here, you can have at most a maximum of 1 cell here. You cannot have 2 cells shaded because both of these 3 will get a contradiction, right? So at least 2 cells would have to be here. For the 4 here, at least 2 cells would have to be here. Because you'll have a maximum of 2 cells here, the other 2 cells would have to be this way. And for the 2, at least 1 cell would have to be here. Okay. A really difficult puzzle this is. At the start the logic was easy, but now it's all about eliminations and how you eliminate each and every cell being a white or a black cell, right? And let's see. These cells will surely help you somewhere. For 7 here, you can have 1 cell here, 1 and 2, 3 and 4. You can have only 5th cell here. You cannot have both the cells. So which means at least these 2 cells would have to be shared. That's an excellent piece of logic. It was really difficult to see for the 7 here. Again, I'll just brief you here what I did is, you can have 2 cells here, 2 cells here and 1 cell here, not 2, right? Not 2 or 3 or anywhere. So you'll have 5 cells in total for these 3 directions. So at least 2 cells would have to be here. Okay. For this 3, no. Okay, for this 8, okay, you have 1, 2, 3, 4. You can have only 1 cell at a max in this direction, 5, so 6, 7, 8 would have to be here. Nice. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8th cell can still be here or here. We are not sure of it, but we have marked the 7 cells here already. This shaded cell will have to come out using this way only, right? Okay. Anything else you are missing here? No, I'm not getting anything with this. Oh, for the 3 here, I see that you have to have 3 cells shaded, right? You can have 2 cells shaded here if you shade this. You can have 2 cells shaded here if you shade this. You can have 2 cells shaded if you shade this. And I need one more cell actually. So I cannot shade both of these cells. You'll have 4 cells or both of these or both of these. Which means that this cell would have to be shaded. Wow, that is awesome. That is a really cool logic here. And which means this would have to be unshaded. Because 3 will have the 2 cells either this way or this way, right? And I see that, wow, that is an amazing logic, guys. Amazing, what an amazing piece of logic this is. This shaded cell will either go up or left. It cannot just get stranded here, right? It will either have to go up or left, and in both the cases the 3 gets fulfilled. If it goes up, you have 3 cells shaded. If it goes to left, 3 cells shaded, which means that this will have to be unshaded. Wow, that is again awesome. And I see one more logic is, this whole group of shaded cell, this or this or this, they are all separately, they are all separate groups, right? They need to be connected with the other group of shaded cells, and all of these groups cannot connect using the right area. They have to go towards the left. For example, let me take you with this shaded cell. If it goes up, 3 is fulfilled, right? This 3 is fulfilled. There is no way that did I see that? Okay, it is still possible, right? I get a contradiction, but that is too complex. I don't want to go ahead with that. Okay, that is an amazing piece of logic, guys. Again, if you see this rectangle here, 3, 3, 1 and 4, okay? Let me say you one logic here is that, if I have this cell as shaded, this 3 will go up, this 3 will go right, this 4 will go up and there is no way for 1. It's kind of a chain technique here. It's kind of a chain technique. If you see here, there is no extra cell that can come between in these 4 sides. So for the 3, it can either go towards the top or right. For this 3, either bottom or right. For this 1, either this or this. And this 4, either this or this. And in any case, this cell would have to be unshaded. Let me say you why. If a 3 goes up, this 3 goes down, this 1 comes down, and this 4 comes down, this is unshaded, right? Same way. If a 3 comes here, this becomes unshaded. Whatever be the case, this cell is unshaded. Now this logic helps us. Wow, what an amazing logic this is. Now if you see here, this group of shaded cell cannot go out using bottom top. Bottom right. Right? From bottom to top. There is no possibility that this group of shaded cell can go up this way. Because now 3 is fulfilled, this is unshaded, and this group of shaded cell gets stranded here. So the whole group here, this whole group will have to go and connect to other group of shaded cells using this logic only. I mean to say there is only one path that it goes using, right? So which means that now, this group, now this cell cannot go towards the left. If it goes towards the left, this gets stranded here. This 3 is fulfilled, this 3 is fulfilled. Awesome. So it will have to go top. This 3 is fulfilled now, and this 4 is also fulfilled now. This 1 is fulfilled. This should be null now. That was the really tough logic here. And this group has to come down now. 3 is done, this 3 is done, this 4 is done, this 1 is done, this 3 is done, right? This 1 comes out this way, this 3 comes, this shaded cell goes up this way, this 3 is done, this 3 is done. It's an amazing piece of logic, guys. And this shaded cell comes out this way. For the 7 here, you have 4, 5, 6 and 7, only one way, right? Okay. And this group of shaded cells come out this way. So for the full 8 to be fulfilled, this would have to be shaded. 8 is also fulfilled, 4 is also fulfilled, 2 is also fulfilled. Wow. So only the end part is remaining here. If this is shaded now, this group of shaded cells come out this way. So for the 6 to happen, you already have 2 shaded cells. You will have 2 more here, so this would have to be shaded, and which means that 6 are done now. And now this group of shaded cell will have to connect using this cell. Wow. So if you see here now, what an excellent piece of puzzle this was. A really mind-blowing puzzle. Canal view puzzle by Prasanna Sheshadri from gmpuzzles.com. If you see here now, the whole group of shaded cell is connected to each other just using a single group of connected cell, right? It's just one single group of connected cells. And if you count the number of shaded cells by the number they are indicated with, they'll have exactly those number of shaded cells, right? That's an excellent piece of puzzle. This was a really different puzzle idea, somewhat a variation of cave, but in a cave puzzle we usually try and watch out the checkerboard pattern here, but the checkerboard pattern here is not required. But that is the only main difference between this canal view puzzle and the cave puzzle here. But just with that one rule or one difference, the puzzle has a really different way of solving, right? So I hope you really enjoyed this puzzle. You understood how to solve a canal view puzzle. So please don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and please do let us know if you have any puzzle request or a Sudoku variant. And do let us know in the comment below, and we'll surely make a video on it. Thank you.